All right, perfect. So that was a great game today, though, right? I mean,
oh, yeah.
Amazing. Yeah, it was cool. Tell me about like some of your thoughts or just any wild thoughts. Could be anything. Any hot takes?
A hot take, probably number one.
Uh huh.
I didn't like how he holds on to the ball.
Mm-hmm.
Get rid of it. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Go. Like sometimes he held on to it for too long, and it's supposed to, like. He's got a defender on his back that's about to steal it. You know what I mean? And he could have easily like gotten into trouble. You know, and but other than that, Upa, I feel like he had a first half. It was kind of
a little iffy.
Pardon?
A little iffy, right?
Yeah. He kind of, but in the second half, he kind of got his act together. I don't want to cuss. I'm going to keep it PG, but to keep it professional.
Right.
In the first half, and for the majority until we scored, Benfica had us under the cosh. I was like, they're going to score here in a minute. They deserve to be, what, 1-0 up at one point? Not necessarily, but
they were pressing us. Yeah, really hard. Yeah, it was crazy.
Their number nine, Charles Darwin, or whatever his name.
Yeah, and then Nunez as well. Like, they were just running at us. Yeah.
For sure.
It was crazy. I can see why they beat Barcelona, by the way. I can see how, like,
not that big of an achievement nowadays, but.
I mean, true. It's still, though, you know? Yeah. No, I don't see Barcelona beating them at Lisbon. I don't see it.
No?
Oh, wait, isn't it?
No.
Is it the Camp Nou?
Yeah.
Really? Okay, I thought they played at the Camp Nou first. So I might have been off.
Stadio de Luz, yeah.
Okay, I see it. I can still see Benfica taking a win, maybe a draw. I'd say a win. I think they're beating Barcelona again.
I mean, I you know what? Yeah, they gave us problems. Well, who's to say they can't finish Barca off? You know what I mean? Like, finish their chances against them.
Exactly. Barca beat Kiev today 1-0, and it wasn't that convincing.
It was only one. You think Barca against Kiev, you're thinking 5-0, 4-0, etc. You know what I mean?
When Iniesta and Xavi were there, when MSN was there, no, they would have steamrolled them, for sure.
It would have been another 7-0 or something, you know? But nowadays, who have they got? Ansu Fati. That kid's going to crap his pants at the Allianz Arena.
Oh, yeah. I heard that he extended until 2028, I believe.
I thought it was 7.
It was 7? It may have been 7. I'm just going off of some memory here. Yeah. But
you're just familiar with 8 and Barca.
Exactly. I hate to break it to you, but it was, yeah, exactly. So, today though, I mean, my man of the match. I know that officially the man of the match, Coleman, right? My man of the match.
Leroy Robb.
Leroy Sané. Leroy FC, it's closed, baby. It is closed.
Been closed since he got here.
All of the haters that have been hating on him and riding on him ever since he had some hard times under Flick playing on the right, out of position, may I add, they need to apologize. They need to turn around and say that they were wrong, you know?
Well, absolutely. What's the saying? The apologies need to be as loud as the disrespect.
Exactly. They really need to be. Yeah, exactly. Sané was fucking great. He was insane. Insane to be honest.
Sané, you know?
Insane, yeah. He has that little quote on Instagram, I believe. Like, insane.
He always puts it.
Yeah.
Puts it on after a win.
And,
Insane.
And you can see why now. He really is insane. Insane, you know? It's crazy. No,
granted, even though his goals, I can kind of see why they gave it to Coman, because did you see that little elastico he did for the offside goal? He turned into Ronaldinho for a second, you know what I mean?
Oh yeah, if that offside goal would have, like, if it wouldn't have been offside, that would have been beautiful. It would have been amazing. Yeah, magical. And he also made a really cool inside run. I don't know exactly at what minute, but he made an inside run and shot it almost. He was really close to scoring that. If he would have scored that one, it would have been crazy. Then I would have said, hey, maybe he's man of the match. But he needed a goal.
But he did a couple of flicks and, no pun intended, he did
right.
A couple of flicks and tricks, but I don't see it, really. I guess he's Mr. Lisbon, that's why they gave it to him.
He is Mr. Lisbon, yeah.
He seems to enjoy our time in Lisbon. the last couple of games.
Our time in Lisbon is always pretty good. It's almost as good as our time in London. But I'd say that, you know, our places in London, the matches, those are still more magical. That's where Gnabry usually shines.
That's where Sarah turns it. Chef's mate. I wanted Pavard to score that volley so much.
Oh, that would have been beautiful.
That would have shut everybody up, man.
Oh, that would have been insane. Yeah. I would have said, even though I've been like super banter on him lately, and I believe he deserves it, by the way, just because he's not informed. I mean, it's not his fault that they keep picking him, you know, when he's not informed. But the thing is that, like, he just needs to push it. He needs to bring it more than he has been. I mean, if that would have gone in, though, you're right. That would have been absolutely beautiful.
But me personally, I don't see all the hate and all the, yes, he's not been our best player. Mm-hmm. It's not to the point, how do you say? It doesn't, he doesn't deserve to be like, oh, sell Pavard, Pav Disney,
right.
Pav Ad. No, you support a club 110% and back all of the players 110%.
Of course.
Even Sar, he may not be the best right back in the world. Well, he is Sar Adona.
He's amongst the top three, okay? Yeah, definitely.
Of all time. He's giving Lam and Cafu a run for his money. No, but for real, like, the only player I can think of that, like, oh, get rid of this guy, mm-hmm. Renato Sanchez and before Flick, Coutinho. Me personally, uh-huh. I did not like Coutinho at all.
Well, you know, all right, I was thinking about it earlier, super hot take. Coutinho for me was better, even though he was in his one season, he was better for me than James was for us.
Do you reckon?
And I'll tell you why. James did not have the Bayern mentality at all. Like, at no point. He never once picked it up. Like, he kept on saying that, you know, the training was too difficult. He didn't want to do the defensive duties. Coutinho started to pick it up towards the end. He was definitely not worth for us paying his fee. Obviously not. Yeah, no. I'm glad we didn't. You know, that would have been a disaster. But I would say that he did better just by his mentality. And he did contribute.
As a super sub by Flick, yeah, I agree with that. But, like, in terms of ability, I don't know. I would rather have James, you know. But
right.
There, Joop must have kept him for a reason, because, let's be real, Joop's the man. You know what I mean?
Joop, like, is the man.
He must have seen something special.
Yeah, of course. I mean, I still, Joop and Flick, they're just too great. I love them both. I love them both.
Joop is the greatest manager of all time. I'm not hearing none of this Sir Alex nonsense, nah.
Oh, no. The only, look, Flick, you can actually have a conversation about that, but he's a Bayern manager. Not Sir Alex, definitely not Klopp. We're not talking about any of them, none of them. None of them hold a candle. Guardiola doesn't hold a candle, okay?
No.
He spent more than $1 billion, still can't win a Champions League with Man City. I mean, no, definitely not.
And how much did we spend? And we have 6 of them. Exactly.
Yeah.
We bought Gerd Müller for 4,000 Deutsche Marks, for Christ's sake. Do you know what I'm saying?
My God, I've spent more money than that on useless things.
I think my Bayern shirt collection costs more than that. And I have 30 of those.
And rest in peace, the legend, by the way. What a player. Yeah. Best of all time. Best of all time.
My greatest ever.
Yep.
I'm not hearing none of this model. Because I heard these guys, I don't know which you watch it on. I watched it on CBS Sports, and I don't know if you heard these guys. They're like, oh, I think Ronaldo's the best goal scorer.
Oh.
Have you heard of him?
Yeah.
Oh, don't get me started.
Yeah, I heard that. But I believe I saw it on ESPN FC. They had, like, on the panel, they also talked about it. Like, oh, who would you say is the best ever? And they even had like Gerd Müller as an option. Like, who would you take? You know? And people were taking Johan Cruyff. People were taking Maradona. People were taking Pelé. You know? And I'm just like, yeah, they're all good, but Gerd Müller was the best.
Did you know? Here's a fun fact. I don't know if you know this. Did you know that Gerd Müller is the only player in football history to score in the Champions League final, World Cup final, and the Euros final? No one else has done all three.
I actually didn't know that statistic, but that's actually insane. No, I mean,
for me, I'm sorry. Top two players of all time, Gerd Müller and Franz Beckenbauer. For me, in my eyes.
Exactly. I mean, who do we say, who would you say today comes closest to them within the Bayern squad?
Like, in terms of elegance, I see Kimmich and Beckenbauer kind of thing, kind of a leader, mm-hmm. kind of elegant. I kind of see that.
Mm-hmm.
And in terms of goal scoring, I see, obviously, Lewa.
Lewandowski and Kimmich. Funnily enough, as well, I'd say our two best players.
And Neuer and Müller.
Yeah, Neuer and Müller as well. Yeah, those four, untouchable. Untouchable. They are amazing. Lucas Hernandez, at this point in his career, I believe he's, what, 25, right? I'd say. At his age, 25, he's better than Ramos was at 25.
That's a hot take, I think.
Definitely hot take, but I say it confidently.
That's a good one because he's won everything already.
He really has. And he reminds me of that type of Ramos player, you know, really.
Rick, he'd punch you up.
Oh, I would hate to play against him. Exactly. But I love having him in the squad. He is great.